Three reasons why you need to strategically look back over the last year. Hey, my dear, I am Leadership Development Coach Kathy Archer, and I'm so glad you're joining me either today or on the replay, where we get to dive a little bit deeper and help you move from that survival mode to thriving in both leadership and life. While you are getting settled and shutting off your phone and making sure you got a little notebook handy, because that's kind of what I like to do, is give you some information, I'm going to pop over and share this into the Confident Women Leaders group. While I'm doing that, feel free to make a note in the chat box, even if you're following along on the replay, and tell me what your favoritist, if that's a word, gift was, or favoritist gift has ever been. Tell me that while I am sharing this into my Confident Women Leaders group. Hang on. I'm curious. I really want to know what your favorite gift has ever been now. Oops, I just shared that publicly. That wasn't what I meant to do. Share to a page. My guess is this is going to go to a lot of people today. And apparently that's okay. Just a sec. Come on. Are you putting your favorite gift in the chat box right now? I hope that you are. Because I'm going to check after and see. Okay. We are posted. So the Confident Women Leaders Group is a group of women leaders who are like you, trying to make sense of leadership and balancing that all with life, and looking to have a group of other women going through a similar situation and having that opportunity to lean in, get some insights, and to learn and grow together. So if that's something you want, the link is up in the notes and you can join the Confident Women Leaders Group. Before we dive into the three reasons why we need to look back at our life over the last year, I want to let you know that Blueprint for Change, the online program that I offer, is now open. And so this might really be of interest to you if you are one of those women leaders who's discontent with life and wanting to sort of figure things out and make some changes. Blueprint for Change offers you a strategy and the motivation to make those changes. When you enroll in Blueprint for Change, you will discover a process for creating your personal and professional strategic plan, thus moving you from that survival mode that we've been talking about to thriving. So you'll move from that current reality of what you're experiencing to the desire that you want. So go to myblueprintforchange.com and discover how you can strategically change your life. Because let's face it, if you don't plan your life, somebody else will. And that's what we're talking about today, is how do you plan your life? Last week, we talked about creating that powerful vision to pull you forward. This week, we're doing that little bit of a pivot and we're shifting and looking backwards and saying, okay, so what is it about that back or that last few 6 months, 3 months or a year? What is it that I can learn from there to take forward as I start to create my life? And so what I wanted to do is give you three reasons today why it's important to look back. Now, before I go on, again, I want to share that there's links up in the notes for you. One of the other links that's up there is each week I give you a guide sheet. So this week is no different. There's a guide sheet up there for you to click on. And it's going to walk you through this strategic review of the last year. And I think it's really important to do that. That's why we're going to talk about the three reasons why it's important today. But I think sometimes we forget that there are things that happened back there that we can learn from. And so that's what I want to help you do today. So here's the three reasons why you need to strategically look back. First one, I'm going to set my book down and make sure I'm not knocking stuff over here. First reason that you need to look back is that we either have sort of two lenses that we look backwards with. One is this negativity bias, where the only thing we see is the crap that happened, everything that went wrong, the stuff that we hated. Or we kind of look back through the past year with rose-colored glasses. Yeah, there were some rough times, but everything was pretty good. And either direction, we kind of gloss over a lot of stuff. We miss the details, we miss the intricacies that kind of are the things that happened that maybe give us guidance or direction or point us someplace. And so when we either have that negativity bias, we just brush it off and say, I just don't want to look back. It was hard. It was tough. It was an awful year. Don't want to relive it again. Or we're like, oh, yeah, everything was wonderful. It was great. And we don't, again, go deeper and check stuff out. We may have missed some of the times that were a little bit difficult and what they might point us to. So the first reason we want to make sure that we are strategically reviewing our last year is because we either have this negativity bias where we're looking at everything bad, or we're looking at it through rose-colored glasses. And we want to get a little bit deeper than that high-level overview. Second reason why we need to have a strategic look back at our life is because when we look back, there are really, really, really sometimes tiny things that can guide us and point us. And we miss those little nuggets and lessons, things that we don't want to repeat, or things that perhaps we would like to grow or build on. And so if we're not slowing down, looking at this strategically, we're missing things like, wow, I was really off my game there. Or this was happening during that period of time, and that helped me get there. Maybe there was people involved in your life. Maybe you were involved in a group or a course, or a maybe you'd just taken a seminar. Maybe you were reading a book. Maybe you were getting more exercise. Maybe there was some chaos in your personal life. Maybe it was a really busy time at work. What was happening at that time that either made it really tough or made it flow a little bit more smoothly? What was it about that time that was happening inside of you? What was your mindset? What was your thought process? And what was happening around you? Those are all things that are really, really important that can help you as you go forward. And if you're not slowing down, looking back strategically, you're going to miss all of those things. So the first reason, again, that we're strategically looking back is that we either look at it with a negativity bias or rose-colored glasses. This is the second one, that if we're not careful and look strategically, we're missing some of the pieces that are going to give us guidance as we go forward. The third reason we need to strategically look back is that it creates a springboard for us going forward. It creates that sort of strong base for us to go, okay, I want more of this, don't want any more of that. I know this helps me get what I want. I know that takes me down the wrong path. And it lays that foundation for us to start building our plan, setting goals, deciding how it is we want to be going forward. And so when you slow down and do some of this strategically looking at what happened, why did it happen, what was going on, what do I want to learn from that, that can guide us as we start to take those steps forward. So what are you looking for when you're taking that strategic look back? Again, you're looking for the lessons. What went well and what didn't go so well, right? What worked? What didn't work? Where was I feeling good and happy and satisfied and full of joy and feeling like I had peace? And where was I grouchy and irritable and run down and feeling like I was back in that survival mode, right? And what was going on then? Again, both inside of me and around me. You're looking for four things when you start to do this. Three things. The first is mindset. We've talked about mindset before around growth and fixed mindset. And so the growth mindset is, I can't do this. I don't know how. This is the way it always is. And you stay stuck in that mode. The growth mindset is where you're like, yeah, maybe it's not working, but I'll figure it out, right? So what was your mindset? What was your thoughts? What was that sort of repeated dialogue that was going on in your head, that mind chatter around, oh my God, this is so overwhelming. I can't do this. Or, wow, you know, I'm learning or growing. This is working. I've got people around me who are helping me. I don't know, but I've got some guidance. Oh, that's a different way of looking at it. Hadn't thought about that before. That's that mindset that I'm talking about. So go back to those events and start looking at what was my mindset at the time? And was that mindset helping me, you know, deal with the situation? Was it helping me grow and develop? Was it helping the people around me? Especially in leadership, Your mindset plays a huge role in what's happening in your group. If you're in a grumpy mood, if you are in that mindset of, oh my God, we're never going to get through this, that tends to rub off on everybody else. If your mindset is, you know, the upper management sucks and they're all out to get us, that's going to rub off on the people around you. If your mindset is instead, yeah, upper management has a difficult role and I don't always agree with them, but we're going to work with what we've got and maybe we're going to advocate for two or three things that we need to get changed. Those are two different mindsets, and that's going to create a way different experience for you and your team. So the reasons we need to do a strategic look back is because we're either looking at it through rose-colored glasses or with that negativity bias. The second reason is if we don't, we're missing all of those nuggets. And the third reason is it's a springboard for going forward. So how we're doing this strategic look back is we're first looking at our mindset. What was I thinking? What was the inner dialogue that was going on? The second thing we're looking for is what were you doing in terms of self-care? Right? This is a critical one that we often miss. And as we start to look back, we can see what was going on at that time around, was I getting enough sleep? Was I taking breaks? Was I eating three meals a day at the right time? Or was I waiting until 2 or 3 or 4 o'clock in the afternoon before I had lunch? So were you eating well? Were you sleeping? You know, were you getting to bed at a decent time, or were you trying to pull, you know, 2 and 3 o'clock in the morning to get through your workload? Were you like struggling getting to sleep? What was going on? Maybe it was all of that anxiety that you were struggling with and you fell into bed at night exhausted, but you still couldn't go to sleep. So that's that sleep pattern, right? Eating, moving, and sleeping. So moving, were you getting up and moving? Were you doing exercise? Were you going to the gym? Were you doing the walks that you intended to do? That all impacts your ability to have a good time in your life, or you're going to start to struggle more, right? So mindset is the first one. Self-care is the second one. And remember, we're getting really, really curious about this. We're being non-judgmental. We're not being critical of ourselves. Oh yeah, you screwed up that period of last year because you weren't, you know, going to the gym or taking care of yourself. Or yeah, if you, you know, would have been doing more of your self-care, you wouldn't have been so grumpy with your family, right? Don't beat yourself up. We're simply looking back non-judgmentally, trying to glean some of those nuggets of lessons. What can I use as a springboard to go forward? What's going to help me have a better year next year? What's going to help me develop the goals I need to and the strategy and the plan? And as I start to create the life I want, remember, we're moving from that survival mode where we're just barely getting by and we're hanging on, and we're moving over to that thriving place where we're feeling like we're making a difference, feeling like we can handle everything, feeling like at the end of the day, we still have energy for the rest of our lives. And so if we want to create that, we have to strategically create that. That's why Blueprint for Change is all about that. And so again, Blueprint for Change, go to myblueprintforchange.com, helps you strategically change the direction of your life. So if you're finding you're bogged down and stuck in this, we're going to go back and do this review now strategically so that you can use that as a springboard to move forward. So you've got the guide sheet from today that's going to help you. But if you want more in-depth help, make sure you go check out myblueprintforchange.com because it's going to give you more of this strategic look as you decide, how do I want to live my life going forward? And then what is it that I need to do differently to get that life? And how do I create those changes in my life? Third way we are going to do this strategic look back, or third thing we're looking for as we do this strategic look back, remember, we're being really, really curious. We're looking at our mindset. We're looking at what we were doing for self-care, eating, moving, sleeping. And then the third one is, what habits and routines did I have in place at that time? You know, what was I doing as I look back and go, you know, that period was a little bit rough. That one maybe went a little bit smoother. What were the habits and routines that I had in place? So I've often gone back and told the story of last year when I was writing my book, that I was consistently getting up every morning, sitting down at my desk for the first hour of the day and writing. Didn't get into anything else, didn't let anything stop that. I consistently had that habit of writing every single morning for an hour. And so whether I was in the draft mode or the editing mode, or whether it was already to my editor and I was working on maybe the marketing copy, I still consistently kept that hour every single morning that I was doing that, right? And so that's an important piece to look at. What routines and habits did you have? One of the things that when I am more productive, I often shut my phone off. I turn it on to airplane mode. That's a habit that I have that helps me keep more consistent, right? So those are the three things that you're getting really, really curious about as you look back. What was your mindset? How are you doing for self-care? And what habits and routines did you have in place? And remember, these are going to be those springboards for you to now look forward and create things. So let me give you a couple examples as I did my look back this year, or have started to. I haven't completed it, but as I look back this year, I start to strategically look at a couple times in my year, one that went really good, one that maybe didn't go quite the way I planned. So the first one was in spring. Now, this is kind of an interesting look back because it's a bigger period of time that I'm looking back. When I look back in the calendar, it's about 3 months. And it's in that 3 months, I had 4 big trips to the city. I did four speaking, like conferences that I was speaking at. I also had my daughter's grad and my son's wedding. So it was a pretty jam-packed 3 months. And there was at one point where I got pretty sick, and it was when I was speaking. And so I was really struggling to, use my voice to speak. I was doing one session, maybe you were in it, where whenever I got the group to do exercises, I was sneaking back to my purse, grabbing out a fisherman's friend to take. And I'm thinking, they probably thought I was doing drugs or something, or doing something weird, but it was the only way that I could cope with speaking, was to constantly have something in my throat. So when I look back at that time, and it wasn't that it didn't go great or fabulous, it's just that it wasn't quite as smooth as I would have hoped. So I look back first and I look at my mindset. My mindset was clearly, oh my God, this is a busy time. We just kind of need to get through it, right? So I didn't have a mindset of necessarily thriving. I had a mindset of survival. My mindset was pretty clearly, I just have to get through this week, just have to get through today, just have to survive this next event, just need to get through this travel or this trip, right? That was kind of my mindset. And so it was a bit of that overwhelmed mindset. There's so much going on. And that was often the mind chatter going through my head. My self-care and my habits, both of them kind of go together. My sleep wasn't as good because I was traveling and I was doing a little bit more. And so it wasn't bad, but there was some times where I didn't quite get the sleep I wanted. But not just sleep. For me, a lot of what I find helps me to be more productive is little tiny bits of downtime during the day. So my lunch break or a coffee break, where I take a little bit of time to almost disconnect from my work for a few minutes before I re-engage. And I was missing some of those time frames because I had things so close together during the day and between trips that I was, cramming them together. My habits became, again, that survival mode, putting out fires, just dealing with whatever was on my plate. I wasn't, doing that high level outlook. I actually found my to-do list. I always have my work to-do list that has basically 3 things on it every day. But I had this massive to-do list of a whole bunch of other things that were connected to our personal lives, the wedding and grad, that was, consuming a lot of my thought process. So I had a lot going on. So I can look back on that, I can pull out some lessons. Again, the habits were really important around taking those mini breaks during the day. That's something that I know I absolutely need to do. So no matter how busy it is, I have to figure out how to have micro times of rest and renewal. And again, that could be 1 or 2 or 3 or 5 minutes. It doesn't have to be a half hour or an hour, but I need to make sure that throughout my day, I disconnect from work before I re-engage. So a lesson learned. Okay, another time in my life that went a little bit better this past year. And it was in the sort of August, September period where I was working on my audiobook. And here's what's interesting. The other 3 months that I was talking about, I had a cold then. During August, September, I ended up with a really bad sinus infection. And I was trying to do my audiobook. Doesn't quite work when your voice is coming across not so good, right? And so yet, in spite of that, it was, when I look back, it was a time period that I was really on my game. I was really focused and I felt really productive. So what was different? My mindset was that growth mindset. I can figure this out. I didn't know how to do my book, had no idea how to create an audiobook or how to create a home studio so that I could do that. But I kept my mind open knowing that maybe I can't actually speak right now because I have this sinus infection, but I can continue to grow and learn and figure the rest of it out. And one of the things that I did was the habits that I was doing, I created those habits of that period of time every day where I worked on my audiobook. That was it. That was the only thing I did was work on my audiobook. And so even though my voice sounded wonky, I still practiced and I still turned on the recording and I created, you know, the rhythm, the habit, the routine of doing it every single day. So my mindset was, when my cold is done, when my sinus infection is done, I'll be ready to do this. I'm laying the foundation, right? And my self-care habits then, again, really rigid. I'm pretty rigid at the best of times, but I was, you know, amping it up a little bit, making sure that I was doing all of my 10,000 steps, making sure that I was getting walks every day, making sure that I was getting the rest. So I can look at those two situations again, and I can glean those insights into what was going on for me, what worked for me that I want to use going forward. So you can see some of those lessons that I learned. So again, today we're talking about why you need to look back, and you need to do that review back. And I, you know, often liken it to the inner guidance cycle that I talk about in Mastering Confidence. You need to pause and ponder. And that's what we're doing here. We're pausing, taking a look back. You can use the guide sheet that I've given you this time around to help you, silverrivercoaching.com/guides. You're going to pause and ponder. And as you do that pondering strategically, as you're doing that look back over the last year strategically, you're probably going to do some of those pivots. Oh, I see. That's where things were going so well. I need to do more of that. I'm a much stronger, more productive person when I create these habits. When my mindset is like this, I feel more on my game. And at the end of the day, I feel more relaxed, right? So that's that pivot piece. Then we're going to proceed back into action as we start in the coming weeks to develop your personal and professional strategic plan for going forward. What is it that you want to do? How do you want to create that life differently and move from surviving to thriving? You got to be strategic about it, because if you don't plan your life, somebody else is going to plan it for you. They're going to tell you what you're doing each day, they're going to tell you what's the most important priorities, and they're going to dictate the way your career goes. If you don't plan your life, someone else will plan it for you. So you need to do this strategic look back, and then we need to do that pivot where we're pulling and moving towards that powerful vision that we created last week. So those are the strategies that I want you to use. If you go get the guide sheet, it's going to walk you through all of this so that you can start to do that strategic look back. And then next week, we're going to do that review forward. So remember, if you want more of this, if this is something that you're ready to dive in deeper, and I know that some of you are looking forward into the next few weeks going, you know what, I have some time off at Christmas, and that's usually my time where I start to reflect and I start to do a little bit of a look back and look forward. Maybe I create New Year's resolutions or goals. If that's you and you want to sort of jump into that, then go to myblueprintforchange.com. Remember, this is the online program for women who are a bit discontent with life and want to find that way to find a system to to create the life they desire. When you enroll in Blueprint for Change, you're going to find that system, that process, and the motivation to create your personal and professional strategic plan. Often what we do in organizations is we have our, you know, performance appraisal, and we do this little bit of a plan at work, but it's mostly guided or sort of directed by what the company wants or the organization wants from you. This is bigger. This is a bigger look at how does my personal and professional life fit together? Where am I going in my career? Because it may not be just in this organization. It helps you take that look back, step back, and get that bigger picture look at where am I now? Where do I want to be? And what are the steps I need to do to get there? So when you jump into Blueprint for Change and you enroll in it, you're going to get guided through that whole process where you look at where am I now? You do that little bit of a look back. What's important to me? What are my values? You create that bigger, stronger pull forward, that vision about where is it that I want to go? And then you jump back and start to create those steps to how to get there. And so you're going to strategically create your life. You're going to change the direction strategically rather than just sort of waiting to see what happens or hoping this time period is over or just sliding through. You are going to start to plan, to create a blueprint, to design your life the way you want to. So again, myblueprintforchange.com, check it out, jump in there, self-paced online program, 28 worksheets, 30 some videos. I'm in there to guide you. You can get coaching with it if you want, if that's the level you want to go. But it's going to sort of allow you to create this blueprint, this plan, this guide for you to move from survival mode to thriving in both leadership and life. Thank you for listening today. If you have any questions, pop them in. I'm here for a minute longer. I always forget to tell you that at the beginning. You can always ask questions anytime throughout as I ramble on. The guide sheet is up at the top. SilverRiverCoaching.com/guides will get you access to all of the guide sheets that I've done. We are on guide sheet number 28 this week, so know that there's 27 other guide sheets there. There's also links there to go to each of these live videos if you've missed one of them that sort of corresponds with the guide sheet. If you are interested in strategically creating your plan to move forward, go to myblueprintforchange.com and I will talk to you next week, my dear.